Good morning, students. In previous session, we discussed about what you mean by overloading, how we are going to perform overloading in C++, right? There are two types of overloading techniques are there. First one is the function overloading. Second one is the operator overloading. In function overloading, we are going to take the function name, we are going to repeating the function name, and the function definition must be different, and those functions are going to be present in the same scope, right? Here in this session, we are going to discuss about what you mean by operator overloading. Here operator overloading means, here what do you mean by operator? Operator is an entity which is used to perform a specific task. Operator is an entity which is used to perform a specific task. Here, what do you, here for example, plus, minus, star, divide, percentile, all these are different types of operators, right? What is the use of these operators? These operators are going to use to perform a specific task on the primitive data types, right? What do you mean by primitive data types? Primitive data types means built-in data types. Already those data types are predefined data types, right? For example, integer is there, integer, float, character, all these are primitive data types, right? Whenever we are going to use these operators on these primitive data types, here those operators are going to perform various types of tasks on that particular data. For example, 2 plus 3, what do you mean by 2 plus 3? What is the answer of this 2 plus 3? 5, right? Here we are assigning some work, we are assigning some work to that particular operator. Here all these operators are predefined. All these operators are predefined operators, and functionality of the operators are also be predefined. Here plus means that particular operator is going to perform addition operation. Minus means that particular operator is going to perform minus operation, subtraction operation, right? Here we operators are going to perform their own functionality on the primitive data types. Primitive data types are integer, float, character. While we are going to use user-defined data types, while we are going to use any user-defined data types, these operators are not going to perform their original operation. These operators are not going to perform their original operations. We have to overload those operators. We have to override the operations of that particular operators, right? In general, what are the derived data types? For example, class is there, right? Class is the derived data type, right? Class is the derived data type. Here I am going to perform the operator overloading in C++. Generally C++ is consisting of classes, right? Here I am going to perform the various types of operations on classes. Here performing the operations on classes means we are going to combining the classes. Performing the operations on the classes. Performing the operations on classes means here generally how the particular class is going to be represented by using the objects. We are going to represent the class, right? By using the object, that particular class is going to be represent, right? Here now plus minus star, all these are operations are there, nah? Now I want to perform these operators on the user defined data types. I want to perform plus, minus, star, divide, percentile operations on user defined data types. Here now how, here directly we can't use these operators. On user defined data types. To use these operators on the user defined data type, we must override the operators. Here, this technique is known as operator overloading. We are going to redefining the definition of that particular operator. In operator overloading. Here, this operator overloading is not present in C language. Whereas in case of C++, operator overloading is possible. Why? Because C++ is the object-oriented programming language as well as structured programming language. That's the reason here operator overloading is possible in C++. right? Operator overloading means, general concept of operator overloading means, just we are going to redefining the operators. We are going to redefining the original operation of that particular operators. Operator overloading is the way of providing new implementation of existing operators to work with the user defined operators, to work with the user defined data types. Here, for example, plus is there, addition is there, na? This plus means addition is there. Here, I am going to, if I want to overload this plus operator, if I want to overload this plus operator, just I have to redefine our new implementation. I have to implement this plus operator. I have to write the code for this plus operator here of existing operator. Plus is already existing operator, right? Plus is already existing operator. So I am going to implement the existing operator. Why we have to write this one? Why we have to perform the new implementation of the existing operator? Why? Because we are going to performing the operations on new user defined data types. We are going to perform the operations on user defined data types. That's the reason we have to perform new implementation. We have to provide the new implementation of existing operators. Existing operators means plus, minus, star, divide, all those are the existing operators. If we are going to use these operators on primitive data types, just like integer, float, character, no need to write the code for that particular operator. Directly we can use those operators. If you want to use these operators on the user defined data type, just like classes, then just like classes or just like objects, we have to write the new code and we have to write the new implementation of that existing operator. An operator can be overloaded by defining a new function. How we are going to perform the operator overloading means, we have to define the new function for that operator. We have to define the new function. Without using the function, we can't overload the operators. By using the functions only, we are going to perform the operator overloading. Here, the function for the operator is declared by using the operator keyword. Operator is the keyword which is going to use to perform operator overloading. Operator is the keyword to perform the operator overloading. Next, I'll check the syntax for this one. See here. First, we have to write the return type. This is the general syntax for this one. Return type, then followed by the operator keyword. Then followed by the, if I am going to overload the plus operator, then I have to write this plus. If I am going to overload the minus operator, just I am going to put the minus. If I am going to overload this star, just I will put star. So next is parameter list. This is just like the function declaration only. In function declaration, what we are going to write? Return type, function name, then parameter list is there. Na? In operator overloading, return type, operator here. In operator overloading, we have to use the operator keyword. In operator overloading, we have to use the operator keyword. That's the reason first we have to write the operator, then followed by the particular operator which we are going to perform, which we are going to overload. For example, here in my example, I am going to overload the plus operator, right? Here, I'll explain with an example how we are going to perform the operator overloading. See here, binary operator plus overloading is there here. How we are going to perform the binary operator plus overloading? First is hash include iostream.h, hash include conio.h is there. Next is using namespace std. Here I am going to define one class, that is rectangle class. Here I am going to defining one class, that is the rectangle. rectangle class is there. In the rectangle class, I am going to overload the operator. I am going to overload the plus operator, right? Next is here in public mode, LEN, BRE, two data members are there. These two data members are declared in private mode. If you are not going to specify any access specifier, then those data members are going to be indirectly, those data members are going to be declared in private mode. See here, I am not going to specifying anything here. That's the reason LEN, BRE, two data members are there. These are going to be declared in the private mode. Next is here, rectangle. Here, this, what is the class name here? Rectangle is the class name here. Here also rectangle is there. What does it mean here? This is the default constructor. Here I am going to declaring one default constructor. In that particular default constructor, I am going to assigning the zero value to LEN, zero value to BRE, right? Length and breadth is there. Here I am in default constructor, I am going to assigning zero value to LEN, zero value to BRE, zero value to LEN and zero value to BRE, right? Yeah, one class is there, that is the rectangle class. In rectangle class, two data members are present, LEN and BRE. Here we are not going to specify any access specifier, public or private. That's the reason those data members belongs to private access specifying mode. Here next I am going to declaring one constructor, that is the rectangle. Here that is the default. We are not going to pass any parameter. That's the reason that particular constructor is known as the default constructor. Now I am going to assigning zero value to LEN, zero value to BRE. Next, here in the same class, I am going to defining one more parameterized constructor. One more constructor, that particular constructor is a parameterized constructor. In this parameterized constructor, I am going to pass two parameters, x comma y. X comma y. Two parameters are there, x comma y. Here, LEN equals to x. Here, BR equals to y. Here, I am going to assigning x value to LEN, y value to BRE. In previous case, I am going to assigning 0 value to LEN, 0 value to breadth. Here, I am going to pass two parameters, x comma y. X is going to assign to LEN variable and y is going to assign to breadth. Y is going to assign to breadth, right? This is the parameterized constructor. Now, here I am going to perform operator, binary operator plus. I am going to perform binary operator plus on the operators on here, on the objects, right? See here. Already I told that operator overloading means we are going to write the new implementation of the existing operators, new implementation of the existing operators on the user defined data type. In this example, I am taking class as a user defined data type. In this example, I am going to take as a class as a user defined data type. If you want to perform any operation on class, it means that I am going to perform the operations on the objects. To represent any class, we have to use the object. To represent any class, we have to use the object. Here, we are performing any operation on the class. Indirectly, it means that we are performing the operations on objects. We are performing the operations on objects. Now I am going to overload. I am going to performing the plus operator overloading, addition operator overloading. Here addition operator overloading means here I am going to perform the operations on objects. I want to perform the plus operation on object, right? Why? Because objects are the user class is the user defined data type. Now in operator overloading, we are going to perform the operations on the user defined data types. That's the reason I am going to performing the operations on the objects. Here plus means those, I am going to combining those two objects. Here see here, rectangle R. Here what do you mean by this rectangle R? This R is the object. This R is the object. Why? Because here, how we are going to create the object, class name followed by the object name, right? Class name followed by the object name. See here, in this case, what is my class name? Class name is rectangle. Class name is rectangle. See here, I am creating the object. Here I am creating the object, rectangle R. R is the object. R dot LEN equals to LEN plus R dot LEN. See here. I am creating one object R. Here also operator overloading is there. First return type. Here What is the return type for this constructor? Constructor is going to return nothing. Constructor is not going to return anything. That's the reason here we are going to write the rectangle, then followed by the operator, followed by the operator, then plus. Plus is the, I am going to perform the plus operator overloading, plus operator overloading. Then here I am creating one object, rectangle REC, rectangle REC. REC is one object. REC is one object. R dot len equals to, what is len? Len is already, we are assigning the value. Len value is there. Then REC dot len, REC dot len means we are accessing this length variable by using this object REC. By using this object REC. Next is R dot BRE means we are accessing this. We are, BRE is there. BRE is the private data member. To access the private data member outside the class, we have to create the object. By using that particular object only, we can access the private data member of the class. We can access the private data member of the class. R dot BRE equals to BRE dot BRE plus REC dot BRE. Here, see here, R dot len, REC dot len. See here, this is one object. R dot len is going to represent R object. Here, REC dot len is going to represent one more object. It means that we are going to perform the operations on objects. Directly, we can't, for example, here, rectangle. Rectangle R1 comma R2 is there. R1 comma R2 is there. Here directly we can't perform R1 plus R2. Directly we can't perform R1 plus R2. Why? Because these are the user defined data types. These are the user defined data types. Right here, see here, we are going to use one object, that is R. Here we are using one more object, REC. Then we are going to perform addition operation. This is known as the operator overloading. We are performing the plus operator overloading. Now, here I am going to use one more operation, one more function, void display function. Void display, length, what do you mean by length? Length is going to represent by len. Here CR breadth is going to represent by BRE. Just I am going to display the length and breadth of the rectangle by using the operator overloading. See here rectangle R1. Here I am going to create one rectangle R1 2 comma 5. Rectangle R1 2 comma 5. R2 3 comma 4. Here I am creating one parameterized constructor 2 comma 5. I am going to create one more parameterized constructor, that is 3 comma 4. Next, just I am going to create one object R3. Just I am going to create one object, that is R3. Right? First, see out rectangle 1. See out rectangle 1 here. First rectangle here. I am creating first rectangle, second rectangle, and third rectangle. First rectangle, second rectangle, and third rectangle. Here, see out R1 equals R1 2 comma 5. We are passing 2 comma 5 values. Whenever we are going to pass 2 comma 5, directly control goes to this parameterized constructor. This is the parameterized constructor. Now, len equals to 2, BRE equals to 5. LEN equals to 2, BRE equals to 5. Next R2, right? LEN equals to 5, BRE equals to 5. LEN here, LEN equals to 2, BRE equals to 5. First it is going to display the value of LEN equals to 2, BRE equals to 5. Next R2, what is the value of R2? R2 is one more object. Here this is also the parameterized constructor. In this case I am going to pass 3 comma 4 values. Here R2 is, now what is the value of this for this rectangle 2? What is the value of rectangle 2? Rectangle 2 value, LEN value is 3, BRE value is 4. Right? Now, here by using the operator overloading, I am going to perform R3 equals to R1 plus R2. Here, next is, whenever we are going to perform this one, here directly control goes to here. This particular part is going to be executed. Here, what is the value of this one? Here, for this rect here 2, what is the value of len value r1 in rectangle 1, what is the value of len? Len value is 2, right? Length value is 2. In rectangle 2, what is the length value? 3. Whenever I am going to perform addition of these two lengths, I am going to get for this r3, here r3 equals to r1 plus r2. R3 equals to r1 plus r2. Here, whenever I am going to perform this operation, length becomes 2 plus 3 equals to 5. For rectangle 3, for the rectangle 3, here length equals to 5. This y is the length equals to 5. Next, breadth is 5 plus 4 equals to 9. This is the breadth of the rectangle 3. Rectangle. Here, if we are not going to perform any operator overloading, this type of operation is not going to be performed. Right? Here, in this case, we are going to creating three objects. Then we are going to performing the addition in between two objects. Objects are the user-defined data types. Again, here, for example, you see here, I'll give one example. A equals to 5, B equals to 6. 5 plus 6, directly you are going to get 11. 5 plus 6 equals to 11. So, to get this 5 plus 6 equals to 11, is it necessary? Are you going to write any code for this one? 5 plus 6 equals to 11? No, we are not going to write any code for this one. Why? Because 5 is the primitive data type. 5 and 6 both are representing the integer values. This integer value is the primitive data type. Here plus is the operator. Operator is also predefined. Here operator is also predefined entity. Here no need to redefine the operation. Of that particular operator if you are going to perform the operations on the primitive data type. But here objects are there. Here whenever we are going to perform the operations on the objects, user defined data types, we have to overload that particular operator. See here, in this, here we are performing this operator overloading. Whenever we are going to perform operator overloading, operator followed by the operator followed by the which operator you are going to overload, that is here in this example I am going to perform plus operator. That's the reason here I am going to take this plus, right? Length equals to here. First, I am going to display the, here, see here, first R1 dot display is there. So, in R1 dot display, what is the length value? Length value is 2, breadth value is 5. So length equals to 2, breadth equals to 5, right? See here. In second case, R2 is length equals to 3, breadth equals to 4. R2 dot display, see, length equals to 3, breadth in rectangle 2, length equals to 2, breadth equals to 4. In for rectangle 3, we are going to perform, we are going to add R1 comma R2. So 2 plus 3 equals to 5, 5 plus 4 equals to 9, right? This is the operator overloading. Now I am going to implement this operator overloading in Dev C++ software. Okay. We will check this one. Here, what is the first line of our code? Hash include IOStream. Next, what is the next line? Using namespace std, right? Next is class rectangle. Here in private mode I am going to declare len and bre, int len comma bre, length and breadth. Here we are going to declare the constructors in public mode only. Here first I am going to declare the one constructor, rectangle default constructor. What is the value of this? Len equals to 0. breadth equals to br equals to 0. Here this is the default constructor. Here I am going to write, I am going to assign 0 value to len and 0 value to bre. Next I am going to declare one parameterized constructor, right? Rectangle int x comma int y. Here I am going to pass these two parameters, right? X comma y, two parameters are there. So here this is the parameterized constructor. Now I am going to assign x value to len, len equals to x, and breadth value, right, bre, breadth value equals to y, right? See here, this is the parameterized constructor. In this parameterized constructor I am going to pass two parameters, x comma y, right, x comma y parameters. Now rectangle operator, here I am going to redefine this operator overloading, right? Operator here, which operator I am going to overload? Plus operator I am going to overload. That's the reason I have to write plus operator here. Rectangle R. Here I am creating one object. Here I am performing the object operator overloading, plus operator overloading. Here I am creating one object R. I am creating one object R here. In my example I have given REC, na? Right here, rectangle R. R dot len equals to len plus rec dot rectangle len, rec dot len, put the semicolon. Next r dot breadth, bre equals to bre plus rec dot bre, right? Put the semicolon, then return r, close this one. Here we are performing the operator overloading, right? Up to here, class here. Next is, we have to display the values of len and rec. So void display, I'm using one function, void display, open the braces, cout len and l, right? C out bre and l. Here void display function is, here I am defining display function in class rectangle. So here, up to here, class definition is completed. So we have to put this semicolon. Now here, how many functions we are declaring here? First is the default constructor, parameterized constructor, then we are going to perform operator overloading, here rectangle operator plus operating rec, then void display. Now here we have to write the code for the int main, right? Right here, rectangle. Here I am creating three objects here, R1, 2, 5, right, comma R2, don't write this colon, and comma, R2, 4, comma, 5, and R3. Here we are creating three objects, R1, R2 and R3. R1, R2 and R3. Now we are going to perform addition of these two objects, R1, comma, R2. First I am going to display the value. Cout rectangle rectangle 1 values and end L. Here, what are the rectangle 1 values? How we are going to display, how we are going to get the values of rectangle 1? R1 dot display, right? Now see out See, rectangle 2 values. Control C. Here, Control V. Here, rectangle 2 values. How we are going to get the rectangle 2 values? By using this R2 dot display method. End. Right now I am going to perform addition of these two operators, R3 comma R1 comma R2. R3 equals to R1 plus R2. R3 equals to R1 plus R2. Here this statement is indicating the operator overloading. Here we are performing the operator overloading and the user defined data types. Here we are performing the addition. Operation on user defined data type. That's the reason it is known as the operator overloading. Now I am going to display the third value. Control C. Rectangle 3 values and L. Here, to get the rectangle 3 values, which function we have to use? Display function only we have to use na. So R3 dot display, right? Then return 0, close this one. Here, see here, first we are going to take this rectangle in rectangle class. In the rectangle class, here I am going to define two functions. I am going to declare two functions, two data members, len and bre. These two are the private data members. Next I am going to declare one default constructor. Default constructor means we are not going to pass any parameters. In the default constructor, I am going to assigning 0 value to len and 0 value to bre. Next is I am going to write the code for the parameterized constructor. In this parameterized constructor, I am going to pass two parameters, x comma y. Here just I am going to assigning x value to len, y value to bre. This is the parameterized constructor. Now here this is the code for the operator overloading. Here in this case, here in operator overloading, what is the keyword we are going to use here? Operator. Operator is the keyword we must use, then followed by the operator which we are going to perform. So that is the plus is the operator which we are going to be overload. Then here I am going to create one more object, REC object. In this implementation of the operator overloading function, here I am going to create one more object, that is R. By using this R, I am going to performing the operations. Here, without using the functions, we can't perform the operator overloading. Here, display function is there. In display function, just I am going to display the value of len and length and width of the rectangle. First, here In main function, I am going to create three objects, R1, R2, R3. In R1, I am going to pass two parameters. In R2, I am going to pass two parameters. Here, R3 is there. R3 is equivalent of R1 plus R2. I am going to add the values of R1 and R2 to get the values of R3. First, we have to now. I am going to compile this program. First, I have to save this program. Right? Sorry. Save, execute, compile. It is processing the file. Is there error here? Errors are zero, warnings are zero. Now I am going to run this program. What will be my output? Output will be, yeah, first is R1 values are 2, 5. R2 values are, see here, rectangle 1 value, LEN value is 2, breadth value is 5, rectangle 2 values, LEN length value is 4, breadth value is 5, in rectangle 3, length is 6, breadth is 10. Why? Because 2 plus 4, 6, 5 plus 5, 10. Rectangle 3 value is 10. Here, this is the concept of operator overloading. Before going to conclude this, just I will recall the important points on the operator overloading. Here, in operator overloading is going to perform on the predefined operators. Operator overloading is going to perform on the operators only. Here, general operator functions are going to be predefined. Here, whenever we are going to perform any operation on the predefined data types, no need to redefine, no need to implement the operations of that particular operator. Whenever we are going to perform any operations on the user defined data types, we must overload the operators. We must write the code for the new implementation for that particular operator. Without using the functions, we can't overload the operator overloading. Without using the functions, we can't overload the operator overloading. And one more thing, here we have to use the operator keyword. We have to use the operator keyword while we are going to perform the operator overloading operator overloading concept. Here, generally, operator overloading means just we are going to providing the new implementation of existing operators, new implementation for the existing operators, right? Thank you.